You ready, Robbie Hummel?
I am ready to go.
All right, let's get her done. CJ Miles getting that last touch.
Just massaging that basketball.
Oh, tap is won by Zimmerup.
An aggressive toss. Way up there.
Maybe the most irrelevant thing in all of sports is the opening tip of the basketball game.
Don't tell the fans that.
Here's Cantor working against Dom. Easily gets into the paint and scores.
That was like Keith Clanton. Not Karim Cantor the way he just backed down Mike Dom. Got to that strong left hand. Had the whole left side.
Keen darts inside, high off the window. No, good late contest by Cantor. And the ball goes over to zip him up.
Let's see if sideline Cantor can get Marcus Keen going. Did a little bit of everything two nights ago, but just 7 points, 1 of 7 from the field. Did have 6 rebounds, did have 9 assists, but then to make a deep run, he's got to be a scorer as we've seen him in past TBTs.
Winner this game gets Florida TNT tomorrow. Macura with the miss from deep. Cantor picks up the loose ball and scores.
Really casual there by Eric Thompson. Didn't really jump to get that. And Karim Cantor, look what I found at the basket.
Cantor with 2 buckets, one with the left hand, one with the right. Here's Keen. Can't leave him open. He is a sniper to the nth degree.
You jump over the fight right there. He leaves his defender in the dust, turns that ball screen down, and it's a good sign for sideline Cantor. They need Marcus Keen.
Marcus Keen has played in 4 TBTs, all of them with sideline Cantor. Cantor with the misfire. CJ Miles relocates. Missed the three, upset with himself.
Got a good look. Came off that ball screen. Defense is back.
Macura, his first bucket.
Just a total breakdown in sideline Cantor's transition defense. JP Macura, ball coming, and it's right to the basket.
All 3 field goals for Zip 'em Up have been in the paint. And Thompson, the clean rip away by Stainbrook. Numbers for Zip 'em Up. Blew it, got it back. Oh my goodness, I didn't think they were gonna call a foul. Blew it, hit the deck hard, and a late whistle, but a good whistle.
Oh, Eric Thompson going straight up. That was just totally out of control by Trayvon Blewett, unless there was somebody grabbing his arm.
All right, first blush, I thought it was a foul. Let me take a look here.
I don't know what else Eric Thompson can do,
okay.
Honestly.
I'm kind of with you on that. Blewett, an elite free throw shooter. He'll have one more. Blewett, a 4-year player at Xavier, so this floor is very familiar to him. The rims look big, the size of manhole covers. Makes 2 free throws.
Yeah, such a good career here. All-time leader in games played, 2nd in points. Scored over 2,200 points.
And a turnover. Sloppy to begin the game to sideline Cantor. And I'm not sure Mike Dumb has touched the ball yet.
No, I don't think he has. That's kind of how sideline Cantor was against Defeat Diabetes. They let that team hang around. Defeat Diabetes had 7 guys.
Macura off balance. Was hoping for a foul call that never came. Here's Keen, fouled up high by Cantor.
We saw Zip 'em Up is not afraid to take fouls in transition. It was Macura doing a lot of it to stop fast breaks. It's something we talked about 2 nights ago. Is huge overseas, and makes sense. A lot of these Zip 'em Up guys play over there, and that's what they're going to do when this ball comes out in transition.
Double dribble.
He totally double dribbled.
Eric Thompson dribbled, picked it up, and dribbled again.
As long as you just look like you know what you're doing, sometimes you can get away with stuff like that.
Kristen. 18-footer. Everything for Zip 'em Up has either been a layup or a free throw so far in the ballgame. Dom spins on Kristen, off the window and in.
Over the top of Stainbrook, but Samaje Kristen, a little bit of a gamble there. He knows he's giving up some major size to Mike Dom, and just letting Dom get right to his strong right hand.
Blew it. Keene fell down, and he's grabbing his left ankle.
Yeah, that's not good.
And we're going to have to stop play. Marcus Keene is in some pain.
Good to see him walk this one off, because he is such a big part of what sideline cancer has been about.
Walking it off straight to the bench. Oh.
He just steps on that left foot of J.P. Macura and rolls his ankle. Watch his left foot right there.
Well, how about this? Remy Abel comes into the game and gets a nice hand. There are now six players on the floor that are Xavier graduates. You got the five playing for Zip 'Em Up, and now you got Remy Abel, who graduated from Xavier. He's playing for sideline cancer.
Going against the family here.
Also into the game, Kaiser Gates. Gates was a big-time star in the win on Monday. Gates with the rebound.
Good D there by J.P. Macura.
Macura just threw it up, was again hoping for a foul that never came, and Cantor is fouled, grabbing a rebound.
And he's talking, he's playing to somebody in the front row.
Everyone wanted to know he was fouled. Now, something that got Zip 'Em Up really rallying and moving was when J.P. Macura got a technical foul on Monday, he's known to jaw.
He gets himself going, whether it's to the other bench, to the fans, to the popcorn guy, it does not matter.
Long one for Macura. Cantor, another rebound. Sideline Cantor has no answer for Karim Cantor.
That's grown man stuff right there by Cantor. Gets that rebound, brought it down so the guards could have a chance at it, but he muscles it right up through the defense.
Mo Creek has checked into the game for sideline cancer. This is Miles. Pro's pro is C.J. Miles.
Absolutely. I mean, he did that for a long time in the NBA. You're aggressively closing out to him, show the ball. It's a smart play by C.J. Miles to get to his spot.
Blew it. First three-pointer for Zip 'Em Up. This is a Zip 'Em Up team that plays very well together, which is hard to do in this format. Just getting guys together and playing with not a lot of practice time.
You got a real feel. The fact that they have so many Xavier alum playing is so impressive.
In and out for Dom. Changes to tell you about coming in for sideline cancer. This is going to be Nick McGlynn. Third TBT for Nick McGlynn, 25-year-old.
There's that C.J. Miles three. You're closing out aggressively to try to run him off the line, but C.J. Miles able to still get one up. There's Trayvon Blewett. We talked about his scoring exploits here. You give him an open shot, he's going to do you damage.
Kristen was walled up by Remy Abel, still made it. Steal of the inbound by Macura, and he missed.
He is taking some interesting shots here early.
Remy Abel. Numbers, three on one. Blewett, a layup.
Pretty. That ball never hit the ground. It's an outlet pass. It's a look ahead, and Trayvon Blewett finishing the deal in transition.
Sideline Cantor down by nine. It's a 7-0 run for Zip 'Em Up. And now playing here at the Cintas Center, you can see the advantage they have.
Well, I don't know how that's not a foul. C.J. Miles, that was all arm.
Macura. Gates, a Euro. And he'll have free throws. Kaiser Gates is fouled. He'll be at the free throw line when we come back.
Zip 'Em Up is getting out, and they are running, looking up the floor. The balance on display again, but you have got to get back. Zip 'Em Up, a little 7-0 run here in the first quarter.
The basketball tournament is presented by Puma Basketball and by E&J Brandy, the official spirit of TBT.
Every time, right? So if they score, you take it out, four man rotate out, we'll get up and run.
Who's got Dom? Him or I did?
He has Dom.
Okay.
All right. Let's go into Karim though. Let's go four round one. go in, pass, cut, move. If you can't get it in, when it gets back to Miles, sprint into a ball screen. All right? Hey, fellas, keep crashing the offensive glass. Keep rebounding all right and running. Here we go. Let's go.
Let's go, y'all. Zip them up on three. One, two, three. Zip them up.
What's that?
My body is freezing.
You look great.
I need a long sleeve.
So far, so good for Ziv 'Em Up. They lead Sideline Cancer 17-8. TBT action continues across the country through August 2nd, when we'll crown the $1 million champion. Get your tickets to any of TBT's regional sites or the final rounds in Dayton at thetournament.com/tickets. JP Macura, his girlfriend and daughter Stella. I wonder if she's listening to our broadcast. That's pretty cool.
I'm guessing
she's going to great lengths to listen to our broadcast.
A wireless TV headset there.
Kaiser Gates at the free throw line. Makes the first. He'll have another. Kaiser Gates with three mammoth dunks in the win on Monday against Sweet Home Alabama. A lot of juice in those 25-year-old legs. Remy Abel brings it across the timeline. Looks for the screen. McGlynn, tight quarters, lost it.
Another run out.
And a foul in the backcourt stopped the fast break. And now it's Nick McGlynn who is slow to get up. Sideline Cancer is already without Marcus Keene, who looked to turn an ankle in our first quarter, but now Keene's going to come back in.
Zip 'Em Up is living in transition right now. I mean, he's loose balls, off missed shots. They're just looking to push the tempo. Gotten off to a terrific start here in the first quarter.
All right, new point guards for both sides. You got D. Davis for Zip 'Em Up. He's working against Marcus Keene, who's back into the game after apparently turning an ankle. Cantor, bully ball.
Just going four round one, but Marcus Keene coming in and taking his rock.
And Keene is fouled before the shot.
That ankle looked pretty healthy there.
It did.
Come back in the game. Take the ball from Karam Cantor and then off to the races.
Mo Creek leaves. Deontay Garrett in for the first time. Number two, Deontay Garrett, playing in his first TBT. Long three, CJ Miles, his second triple.
Pretty good contest there by Trayvon Blewett, but the type of shooter that CJ Miles is, you cannot give him any space out there on the perimeter.
CJ Miles picks up the loose ball and is fouled in the backcourt. CJ Miles spent 16 years in the NBA, made 16 years of NBA money, and he's wearing those Puma shoes because he wants an extra 1,000 for an Elam Ender.
The amazing thing is that he's 16 years in the league, and he's only 35 years old.
Isn't that crazy?
It's one of those deals where when you come out of high school, you can stay around, you can play for a long time.
1,250 career three-pointers made for C.J. Miles.
It'd be quite the pension he gets. It's all about years acquired.
Marcus Keene up and down. For the 2 years that he spent playing in Canada for the Toronto Raptors, he was known as C.J. Kilometers.
Aha, there you go.
How about that? Deep shot made by Cantor. He has been everything here in the first quarter for Zip 'Em Up.
Ultra aggressive, and they're showing off the stroke.
Keen, wonderful hesitation. Man, smallest man on the floor, dipping and diving, works that baseline, and he's got a chance for a three-point play.
He absolutely froze D. Davis. That hesitation was major league, and after the hezzy, it's all about the burst, and Marcus Keen as good as anybody at using that burst to get to the rim.
5'9", Marcus Keen, now 27 years of age, missed the free throw. Cantor so far has 9 points in our first quarter. Caleb Cantor, lead is 7 for Zip 'Em Up. Blow it. Trying to save the ball, Nate Johnson, who had just checked into the game. This is a 5-on-4.
That should have went in to Caleb Cantor. They were able to guard him. Boy, the rim is just wide open.
Keen is fouled shooting 3. That all started because Zip 'Em Up didn't really have a feeling for what they're doing defensively. It was a 5-on-4, and everyone's trying to scatter and try and get where they need to be, and it results in 3 free throws for Keen.
Well, it's funny how that works out, where you take an ill-advised shot, and your defense just isn't set. Now you're in scramble mode. D. Davis doesn't give any space for Marcus Keen to land. That's the right call and an easy call for the officials. And boy, that's 2 in a row that Keen has let get away from at the free throw line.
Coming into the game for Zip 'Em Up, Riley LeChance, first time we've seen him. He wears number 13. Matt Stainbrook back in, starting center. And also into the game, Justin Martin. He's number 19 in white. Meatloaf special for Marcus Keen. 2 out of 3 ain't bad. Here's LeChance in the backcourt. And they break the pressure. Great cut. What a find. Johnson gets Martin at the rim.
Better get back, though. That's a heck of a transition offense there. Sideline cancer right back at you.
McClendon, the transition layup. Final 60 seconds of our first quarter. Zip 'Em Up with a whole bunch of offense. 24 points in 8 minutes. Gates. Stainbrook a rebound. Martin. Keen hoping for a foul. Let's see if Zip 'Em Up, they hold for the final shot. LeChance.
There's pace.
Takes a chance and hits a 3.
It's insane. It's just back and forth. And there you go. That's what Riley LeChance is out there to do. A pure shooter. Proved that in his 4 years at Vanderbilt. And right there getting an opportunity and sticking it.
Garrett has to fire, and the shot goes begging, and that's the way our first quarter draws to a close. A scoring flourish by Zip 'Em Up. Team made up of Xavier alums putting up 27 points in 9 minutes. Pretty impressive stuff. To the second quarter we go. It's a 27-19 lead for Zip 'Em Up.
Be fucking fine, all right? What we're gonna do is we're gonna take care of the ball. When we get a clean rebound, we're gonna fucking run. When we miss a shot, we're gonna crash the glass, we're gonna put it back in, we're gonna fucking score. Here's what we got. Listen, Matt, you're gonna take it out, get it to Riley, get open. You're gonna trail. I want a stagger straight away for Nate. I want to come off Kaiser. Kaiser, roll the fucking hoop, throw it to him for the dunk. All right? On this side of the court, start fucking talking, know where your shooters are at, rebound. That's simple. Let's go.
Keep rebounding.
Zip 'Em Up, 1-3, 1-2-3.
I like it.
Where I'm starting at.
Right here in this corner.
Starting that corner.
Defense, we get stops. We have to have them shooting over contested hands. Rebound and we're out. All right, Tony, you got the four. Go two the whole time. I'm coming with some more size in a minute. All right, but we got to defend and push the pace. Let's go.
We all got a rebound.
1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6. Contested hands, rebound and we're out. All right, Tony, you got the four. Go two the whole time. I'm coming with some more size in a minute. All right, but we got to defend and push the pace. Let's go.
We all got a rebound.
1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6.
That in the huddle brought to you by Puma Basketball. That is Charlie Parker, head coach for Sideline Cancer. I wonder if his nickname is Bird. The great jazz saxophonist, Charlie Parker. His nickname is Yard Bird. As you call that, Charlie Parker Bird. Love it. Second quarter action. Into the ball game for the first time in our second quarter. Tony Crocker, he wears number 8. Didn't play a lot in the first quarter. Marcus Keene. And that's travel. Crocker travels. Crocker didn't play at all in that first quarter. He actually started.
Oh, yeah, he played a lot.
He started in the win against Defeat Diabetes on Monday and then didn't play at all in that first quarter.
Sideline Cancer had raved about him. What he was going to bring this year as a new player to their team. Play a versatile piece in that backcourt.
All right, zip him up right now, playing with Gates, LeChance, Johnson, Stainbrook, and Martin. Their only starter right now on the floor for Zip 'em Up is their center, Stainbrook.
They're just so deep. They've got pros, whether it's G League or overseas, stacked on that bench. And when they bring that second unit in, it's a talented group.
Look at McGlynn giving it up.
Good back screen. What a play by Justin Martin to free up Kaiser Gates and then under out of bounds.
Kaiser Gates' his first dunk after having 3 dunks on Monday against Sweet Home Alabama. If you can get a dunk on an out of bounds play, you've done something right.
Give a lot of credit though to Rick Carter. That's a really good out of bounds under OB play. And your Sideline Cancer, your main priority has got to be initially, we're protecting the rim. I know you're concerned if you're Tony Crocker about Justin Martin coming off, but that layup is about 100% shot.
Sideline Cancer, they can't save it. They had 2 guys right there at the half court line, but neither Crocker nor Bogues can keep the ball on the offensive side.
I wonder how long Mike Dom is going to sit over there. It's a 10-point game right now. Dom has 2 points on 2 shots.
LeChance, deep penetration, missed the layup. Eric Thompson back into the game, had his hands on the ball and got fouled by Stainbrook. Oh man, a whole host of changes to zip him up. 4 different Zip 'em Up players coming into the game. Macura, Kristen, Blewett, and Cantor all return for Zip 'em Up.
That normally implies that coach is mad at that whole unit when you see a substitution like that, but I thought that group had done some really good things out on the floor.
CJ Miles comes back in for Sideline Cancer. He replaces Tony Crocker. Jamel Artis swings it to Bogues. Tough chance.
What a contest there by Carol Cantor, just getting out there and having a sense of urgency and contesting that Shannon Bogues jumper.
No, come on.
He won.
Oh, my goodness. Kaiser Gates, what was that?
You saw him two nights ago. You know he's trying to get him up from three. He might be known for his dunks, but he's going to chuck him up, too.
Oh, my goodness. 8-0 run. The Hail Mary answered with 28 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Macura runs down the loose ball. Two in a row for Gates. Marcus King gets so low to the ground, and he's fun to watch. He is so quick and low to the ground, man. It's like trying to catch fog in a sack.
It's like a running back, I mean, and one of those speed backs as well. Here's your boy right here. Oh, Kaiser Gates just stepping in, going glass. I don't think Shannon Bogues thought there was any way he was going to shoot that. I guess that just means he didn't watch the game two nights ago. Bogues all the way to the rim, and he said it. He's quite the blur. The transition, he can be spectacular.
So sideline Cantor has got Marcus Keene, who led all of NCAA basketball in scoring in 2017 when he played at Central Michigan. And they got Mike Dahm, who is in the top 10 all-time in NCAA scoring with over 3,000 points when he was at South Dakota State.
3,000 points is an incredible achievement. I mean, 2,000 in itself is a crazy number, but 3,000 is unbelievable.
He missed the free throw. His buddy Thompson got the rebound, got it back to him, and he makes the three. Nice possession for Marcus Keene. 9-point lead for Zip 'em Up. A lot of dribbling for Kristen. Oh my goodness, did he get bailed out?
Yes, he did.
Oh my goodness. Jamel Artis fouled him, and Kristen will have free throws.
The referee's saying he just encroached into his space and got him in his midsection, but you've done your job. You've stayed in front of the ball, you forced a contested tough 15-footer, and we'll see here if he. He just kind of gives him a tap there. It's one of those deals where you're trying to pull the vet move, and the ref's standing right there. He saw the whole thing.
Kristen made some NBA money. He's wearing his Pumas. ...34-23 is our score. Oh, my goodness. And Artis called for the foul as Macura hits the deck. And that hurt Macura, but he's not going to let anyone know that it hurt.
Oh, man. I haven't seen them jawing or anything leading up to that, but I'd maybe keep my eyes on those two. Macura guarding Jamel Artis, and he's going to try to post him up. And boy, that's some good acting is what that is.
Now, those men are familiar with each other. They both have spent time in and out of the NBA and the G League, so maybe there's something there. We've got a timeout on the floor, 6:17 remaining, second quarter. Remaining in our first half. Zip 'em Up leads by 11. They've got the basketball. J.P. Macura picks it up, hands it over to Samaje Kristen. Kristen likes that pull-up from 18 feet, doesn't he?
He made it two nights ago, but that's a couple there that have been a while.
Here's Mike Dahm. See if he can get going. It has been a very quiet first half for Dahm.
It's a smart way to get yourself going. If Kaiser Gates wants to really impede your space, you just rip right through and draw an easy foul. Try to get yourself to the basket. He's such a threat to shoot that it makes him really dangerous as a driver as well.
Dom now 26 years of age. Miles. Right to Marcus Keene.
Tyler Gates. A little awareness right there. CJ Miles is coming off that screen and his defender gets picked off, but Gates, so aware, he jumps out and makes that, instead of a wide open shot, a contested one.
Remy Abel. Miles.
That's pretty.
Score the goal with a foul. C.J. Miles.
Zip him up, just totally in rotations. And C.J. Miles once again using that head fake. And now instead of stepping aside, it's going to be all the way to the rim. That behind the back, the change of direction there. Takes some contact, finger rolls it up. It's good stuff from an NBA veteran.
First TBT for C.J. Miles. Kristen Cantor, Gates, Blewett, Macura. Five on the floor for Zip 'em Up. Wild shot by Cantor.
Really trying to get back to that strong left hand. This one where if he goes up with his right, I think he probably finishes it.
Rebound to Thompson. And Thompson is fouled by Cantor.
Gotta get the bench too for a technical foul.
Yep. So a veteran move by C.J. Miles as he wins the race to the free throw line. Shoot technical free throws.
Good play. Get those numbers up. Thompson on the offensive rebound. Now he's going to go back up.
C.J. Miles thought he only had one free throw. I said, come on back and get another one. He walked away from the line. Ooh, yeah. Yeah. Dropping of the clipboard.
This could be a four-point play off the free throw line here.
Makes this one, they get the rebound. It could be a six-point possession. All right, it's still holding. They've gotten three straight points at the free throw line. It is a five-point game. So they'll have to settle for the three free throws. 5 minutes to play, first half. Picked off by Miles. C.J. Miles is still frisky at the age of 35.
That's one where Trayvon Blewett has got to just give a simple ball fake, and you've got to get that in there. Macura's got the mismatch.
Take on Florida TNT in tomorrow's championship game of the Xavier Regional. How did Cantor not get vertigo? He turned around three different times and hits it.
He used to do that to his right hand was Luis Scola. And that's a Scola-esque move, but instead of going to the right, you're going to the left. And that's where Cantor wants to go, and he knows how to get there.
Scola from Argentina. You got Cantor from Turkey. Remy Abel! Three-pointer for the former Xavier Musketeer coming back home to the Cintas Center. 13-4 run for Sideline Cancer. You knew they weren't going to go away.
It's too experienced. They've had too many guys win a lot of games in this event.
Here comes Keene. And oh my goodness! How did that go in? again off the fingers of Dahl. And it's a two-point game.
I don't think I've ever seen that before.
The bullet pass from Keane goes through the fingertips of Dahl off the window and in. When you score 3,000 points in your college career.
You find ways,
yep.
And the ball finds ways. I mean, this is just ridiculous. The bullet pass off the fingers of Mike Dahl. Never a doubt.
We got to get second chances. We got to stay tough. Let's go.
Sideline Cancer was down 13 points. They've gone on a 15-4 run to make this a two-point game. For Sideline Cancer, their winning prize will be sent with Zelle. Coaches and players both getting the same amount. Fans can win two at thetournament.com/Zelle. Obviously, Sideline Cancer playing for a cause. So that's why the dollar figure is a little bit lower than what we're accustomed to seeing. And the poke away.
What a pass.
That is going to tie the ball game at 36. Eric Thompson off the feed from Marcus Keane. Cantor.
He's trying to get to this left hand. Mike Dahl, you can see he knew it, but he still gets there anyway.
Cantor is the only zip him up player in double figures. He's got 11, and now he's got two free throws coming. Cantor's brother, longtime NBA forward center, the former Ennis Cantor, now Ennis Freedom.
Jerem Cantor has been a guy that has gone overseas and just played his way into the best leagues in Europe. I mean, he's played in the ACB in Spain, he's played in Greece, this last year played in Eurocup and won the Polish championship. He has really blossomed as a player. He was a good player here, but he's had a really good start to his pro career.
Sideline Cancer, they have never led. They trailed by as many as 13, now down by two. Dahl didn't sense the double team coming, and a foul by Kristen. Free throws 12 and 13 for Sideline Cancer. Mike Dahl last year played for House of Pain. disappointing run for them. Coming out of the Peoria Regional. And this year, Mike Dahm, a free agent, signing with Sideline Cancer to play TBT. And he was phenomenal in the win on Monday against Defeat Diabetes.
J.P. Macura, teammates over in Italy. I know Macura recruited him pretty hard. I'm sure was disappointed to see they didn't get him.
Another long two for Samaje Kristen. That's now four 18-footers he's taken.
Just killing analytics out here.
Yeah, normally people don't care about that stuff 15 years ago, but now they count that. And Blewett is fouled, shooting a three-pointer. C.J. Miles got him. All right, Trayvon Blewett, Indiana native. Three free throws. You got to make three, right? Right?
We gave it up. You shamed Taylor Persons into this, and now you're going to go Trayvon Blewett out of Indianapolis as well, huh?
Blewett, high school teammates with Yogi Farrell, Park Tudor High School. All right, you know Yogi Farrell for years. What's his real first name?
Kevin.
Ah, thought I could sneak one past you. Trying to get Indiana basketball
Indiana
trivia
guy,
past you is like trying to get a cheese past a rat. It's not going to happen. All right, one more for Blewett as he tries to go three for three. Yeah, he can go back home to Indiana whenever you want.
He can return.
Yep, you make all three free throws, you're good to go. Marcus Keene, just a blur.
Good help defense, and they came over and just cut the baseline off.
Nate Johnson relocates.
What an effort, though, by Keene to get back in that play in the initial pump fake, then got back into it after that.
And Remy Abel is fouled. And how quickly did the warm reception for Remy Abel fade? He's a former Xavier Musketeer, but he's playing against Zip 'Em Up, and he's no longer getting that nice applause.
We'll see. They just showed it again in the that's straight ball. There's a reason, a good reason, why the crowd is so upset with that call.
Now, we're not the only game in town. Also, tonight, TBT action, you got the championship of the Rucker Park Regional. And that's on the right side of your screen. That's going on live right now over on ESPN. And another foul.
That's a travel.
Oh, it's a travel. You're right. So Remy Abel misses two free throws and then travels. It's been a tough 10 seconds for Remy Abel. And we've got a timeout on the floor. Three-point game. Zip 'Em Up leads Sideline Cancer. We're back, 2:06 remaining in our first half. Sideline Cancer's done a nice job of getting back into this ball game. They're down big early, but it is now a three-point game. They're on defense. Cantor, Kristen, Johnson, Blewett, Stainbrook. Five on the floor for Zip 'Em Up. Cantor lost it. Turnover.
I thought they had him initially. It was a flare screen that Cantor seven cut right to the rim. And a little late on the pass, and then the
seven
pass
cut. I've never heard that. What's a seven cut?
So if you take a flare screen, instead of just taking it to the three-point line, you would seven cut it, like a seven, to the basket.
Okay, thank you. Jamel Artis up and in.
This crowd is not happy with these officials.
Cantor fumbled it, still put it up there. Oh, a three-pointer! Carol Cantor, his second triple of the first half.
Usually as a shooter, if you fumble that thing, you're better off moving it. There's not many guys that can fumble it, recover it, Steph Curry comes to mind as a guy that can, but pretty impressive by Cantor on that play.
Stainbrook, last touched by. How is it possible the Marcus Kane
was
at 5'9
the same thing.
Was the last person to touch it over Stainbrook, who's listed at 6'10?
It's a credit to Marcus Keane's athleticism, I suppose.
J.P. Macura comes in for the final 69 seconds of our first half. Macura. Been a real slow first half for him.
He's taking some really tough shots.
Numbers for Zip 'Em Up. J.P. Macura finally got a shot he could make.
Took an easy one. I mean, pause, let the defense fly by. They were so worried about everybody else. And Jamel Artis, where are you going?
Another turnover. And Macura forces the contact. Artis fouls him. Macura to the line.
You never pick your dribble up when you just cross half court. That's exactly what Jamel Artis did, and he threw a hand grenade. Just nowhere to go. This is one where if you're Artis, you got to, before you cross half court, compose yourself, cross over. You cannot cross and pick it up like that.
Free throw, just the second missed free throw for Zip 'Em Up. They're 10 for 12 as a team at the line. Tony Crocker, who has played very little here in the first half, he comes in. For Zip 'Em Up, Stainbrook and Cantor lead. And the bookend forwards, Kaiser Gates and Justin Martin, both come in. Sideline Cantor could have went 2 for 1, but they take too much time. And now they call a timeout. Charlie Parker will have thoughts about how to have a positive possession here. We're going to try and sneak in that huddle.
Nick and CJ, right? CJ go over, Nick go under. Set this one for Marcus, all right? We're going to have Remy here. Tony and Remy. Tony go set one for Remy. And then we got an elevator for Tony coming off Marcus back to the top. If you don't have the elevator, CJ, flare off Nick to the wing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hey, run the clock down.
We've seen that elevator screen already for sideline Cantor on an under out of bounds play. This time it's gonna be at the top of the key.
What's an elevator screen?
So it's where you have two guys who come together, and it's technically it can always be a moving screen if the defender runs into it while they're moving. So you have to be careful, but
oh, the elevator door's closing.
Yes, it's like the doors are closing. So now I like what Zip 'Em Up did here. They came out 2-3 zone, and you blow up that play. Now you got to run your zone offense. Zip 'Em Up, they just matched up.
Keane dumped down McLean, a chin up. Oh, Keane had a three-point look, and he said, I prefer the dunk. Good team ball. Macura. Left some meat on the bone. And a foul.
That's why he can't do that.
With 1 second remaining, we're going to pick it up, walk the other way, and have free throws.
You have to get the last shot of the half here if you're Zip 'Em Up. All right, you take it. Now you commit this foul. I mean, take his legs out on Tony Crocker. Just cannot happen if you're Zip 'Em Up.
So Crocker hasn't scored in our first half. Just in case. Cantor's gonna come back in for the final second. I guess this is to get a rebound if there is one. Crocker makes a pair. Macura. Ah! Oh, my goodness. It would have counted if it went. That ball was everything but down. Actually, never came down. It's still above the stanchion.
There's been some weird plays. The Dom layup and now this. I mean, this has been
only
a half.
In TBT. Only in TBT. We've got a one-possession game. 46-43 is our score. Zip them up. Lead sideline cancer. We'll step aside when we come back. We'll talk with one of the stars for Florida TNT and their win earlier today. We're going to talk with Chris Warren. That's in a moment. Stick around.
Turkey.
Oh, good. Cool.
Yeah.
Which one?
A team called Boldrum.
Okay.
Yeah. It's a second division team.
Yep.
Two minutes until we do this, Chris.
How long we going to last?
As long as you want to. We got a halftime for the TBT.
It's like 2 or 2.5 minutes.
Cook it till it's done. This is your 6th TBT, right?
I really don't know.
Team Maryland.
I know I played in a few of them.
Team Maryland, old Hottie Toddy. Team DRC.
You say Team Maryland.
Did you play for that team?
No, I didn't play for Team Maryland.
Okay.
No.
I wrote it down that way. I saw it somewhere.
No.
You play for old Hottie Toddy?
I play for old Hottie Toddy.
What about DRC?
Team DRC.
Okay.
Yeah. No, I have no Maryland ties.
No Maryland ties.
I have no Maryland ties.
Where are you from?
Florida.
What part?
Orlando. Orlando.
Yeah. Yeah. What high school did you go to?
Yeah, I played with TMD. Yeah. Huh. Team TMD.
TMD.
Right. That was kind of like Ole Miss influence, too. Old Hottie Toddy.
Yep.
That makes sense. Hottie Toddy, God Almighty, or something like that?
Yeah.
What was your last year, Ole Miss?
I graduated 2011.
Okay, so then you missed. Did you play with Marshall Anderson?
No, I didn't play with Marshall Anderson.
He was 2012, I think?
He came in, I believe he came in 2012, 2013. I believe so. We played together 1 year. That was with TMD.
Okay.
Okay.
And he's a coach there now, right?
No, not at Ole Miss.
Oh, he's not? I thought he was a GA.
Nah.
No?
I just took a visit up there last week. Nowhere to be seen.
Okay. 31-22. Got it. Is everyone else on your team still here? Did everyone leave? Welcome back, everyone. We've made it to halftime here in our game between Zip 'em Up and Sideline Cancer. TBT action coming your way across the country through August 2nd when we crown the $1 million champion. Get your tickets to any of TBT's regional sites or the final rounds in Dayton at thetournament.com/tickets. Now, we already had one game on this floor earlier today, the Cintas Center here in Cincinnati, Ohio. Victorious was Florida TNT, and really, if you're honest with it, the reason they're victorious is this man right here. Chris Warren went off in the second half. Chris, thank you for joining us. 21 second half points after scoring 3 in the first half. What was the difference for you?
First off, I'm a point guard. So first half, I'm always seeing how the game's going to be. I see what my team needs. In the second half, I figure we need a little more scoring. Even though I didn't shoot well first half, I feel like we need more scoring. I need to be more aggressive. So I came out more aggressive, and we got the dub.
Chris, it felt like in the second half you guys were much more aggressive of getting into the paint. You know, how much of that was maybe said from the coaching staff to, okay, we're not making threes right now. Let's drive the basketball and make things happen off the bounce.
Our main focus was to get it into our big man, Keith. You know what I'm saying? We feel like he's unstoppable. He's a big body. Not too many people can bang with him. So we weren't hitting shots. We was doing a lot of one-on-one. So we'd try to look for inside out. And we kick it to him, let him do his thing. And if they double, we kick out. And then that get us going. And once we get going, it's hard to stop us.
Chris, I'm sure Robbie knows what this felt like, but just give the people at home a sense of what it feels like when you get into that groove and you can put up 21 points in the second half.
That's a beautiful thing. You know, all scorers, I feel like I'm a scorer, so sometimes I score, but I'm a point guard, so I know I have to manage the game. But when you're in that zone, it's just you want the ball all the time. You know what I'm saying? You take easy shots, you want easy shots. And if you don't get them, when you're in your zone, you can make tough shots. You can take tough shots, and no one on the team, they'll be mad.
And I'm just curious. You get next one, Robbie, but that reverse that you just threw up there, you rode the baseline and you threw up some funky reverse off the wrong foot. Have you practiced that in the last 30 years, or is that just something comes and you got the feeling?
It's just a regular layup to me. You know what I'm saying? I came off my regular foot, and that's a regular reverse layup. I felt like it was easy.
This is your sixth TBT. What has been the thing that's kept you coming back to play in this event?
Summer competition. You know what I'm saying? A lot of players, they come home from their overseas bids or just want a good competition. You know, a lot of people don't play basketball during the summer. Like they use it as a vacation. You know what I'm saying? So to use this summer to compete, it's a good thing. It's a good thing.
Chris, thank you for your time. I've loved watching you play over the years, man. Keep on keeping on, okay?
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, that's our guy. Friend of the program, Chris Warren of Florida TNT. His team won a ball game earlier today. They're now 4 wins away from $1 million. Wouldn't that be something? Are you a current or former HBCU student? Do you want to make history with TBT and E&J branding? If so, visit ejtbt.com today to apply for a paid sports internship with TBT. It's all made possible by E&J Brandy. We're going to step aside. When we come back, we'll have first half stats and highlights. See you in a moment on the other side. Now it's a one-possession game. It is a 46-43 lead for Zip 'Em Up over Sideline Cancer as we get ready to begin our third quarter of play with Robbie Hummel. I am Eric Collins, and Robbie, let's take us through some of the highlights you remember.
Well, Zip 'Em Up led by 13, and it's an easy thing to say that Marcus Keene and C.J. Miles had a huge part in bringing these guys back. Keene has been electric, 13 points, 5 assists, coming off a game against Defeat Diabetes where 1-for-7, just 7 points. C.J. Miles has played really well on the offensive end of the floor as well, with 11 points, knocked down 2 threes. But for Zip 'Em Up, it's been all about Karim Cancer. He was aggressive to start, 16 points, 8 rebounds, almost at a double-double at halftime, 6-of-8 from the field, has knocked down 2 threes. He's shown off a little bit of everything, and I promise you this, Eric, he's going to his left hand, as we saw right there.
Cancer had 16 points in 14 minutes. He was 6-for-8 shooting for Zip 'Em Up. As you look at the combined numbers, very similar. Both teams making 5 three-pointers. The turnovers, that's a big number for Sideline Cancer. 5 more turnovers than Zip 'Em Up. All right, Zip 'Em Up is going to have the same 5 on the floor that began the game. Macura, Blewett, Cantor, Stainbrook, Kristen. Kristen working on Keene. Interior pass to Stainbrook. And now that reset. Kristen, a turnaround. He was committed to taking advantage of the matchup with Keene on him.
Just a good flash. I mean, he gave it up, but then realized he still had Marcus Keene on him. Flash to the basketball, makes himself available, and gets that mid-range jumper to go.
Dahm very quiet in the first half. This is Artis. C.J. Miles. Eric Thompson bats it out, keeps it in play for Sideline Cancer. Thompson playing with a big bandage over his right eye. And Mike Dahm is fouled in the act of shooting.
I thought Dahm might have gotten away with a double dribble there. He batted that ball down, corralled it, and then put it on the floor. I guess it's probably considered a loose ball, and it's still a live dribble, so it is the right call. But
yeah, J.P. McCurry, you saw him inside of your screen. He stopped playing defense thinking it was a double dribble. So Dahm now with 6 points. Dahm had 31 in the win on Monday against Defeat Diabetes. Blew it.
You can see that was going up the whole way down.
He was hoping the wind would blow it a little farther.
About another 3 feet.
Keene, Thompson, Miles, Dahm, Artis, the 5 on the floor for Sideline Cancer. Marcus Keene up and in.
He's just so tough coming off that ball screen from the top of the key. Snakes it back, that big is retreating, and he gets right to his pull-up.
Macura. J.P. Macura.
A wise play by J.P. Macura. He understands that defense is switching. He slips right out of it. Gets to that floater.
Keene. Ball went in his hands for very long at all. What a quick release.
He is that type of player in this event. I mean, he has scored at the highest level, been one of the all-time clutch guys with this Elam ending. And you know that if you're going to beat Sideline Cancer, you're going to have to take some massive punches from some of these guys who have been around a long time.
1-point lead for Zip 'Em Up. And Keene fouls Kristen.
That you want to show some help defense here. J.P. McCurry, he comes down and just give Marcus Keene that type of look.
Another great out-of-bounds play for Zip 'Em Up. That's their advantage.
Oh, they have done that all tournament.
McCurry the bucket. It's now a 3-point lead for Zip 'Em Up. And Dahm with some strength and one. Chance to tie the ball game up with a free throw. Yeah, both J.P. Macura and Mike Dahm stepping up their games here in the second half.
Mike Dahm, this is just a blow-by here. He goes right by Macura, and in the pro game, we've got continuation. Macura reaching in, there's contact, and Dahm goes up and just hammers it.
And we're tied at 52. Zip 'em up at one point had a 13-point lead. They've given it all back, and we're tied at 52. Kaiser Gates checks into the game, replacing Karim Cantor. Deep one for Macura. All right, sideline Cantor. They've never led. They've got a chance to take the lead for the first time here.
Macura, you can get that shot whenever you want. I just think that's one where you move the basketball and try to find something better than a 27-foot three.
Dom trying to back down against Gates. Oh, man, that's a tough chance.
And Gates so off balance. And Thompson just making his presence felt on the offensive glass. Steinberg trying to box him out, and there's just nothing he can do. Couldn't move him.
Third foul on Steinberg.
Steinberg is battling, and they're wrapped up. That's a lot of contact on both sides there. Steinberg going to get hit with the foul.
Yeah, we wondered about that shot taken by Macura a moment ago. I think we have our answer. Rick Carter takes him out of the game. He's replaced by Nate Johnson. Key to three! That's the first lead for Sideline Cancer.
Marcus Keene all of a sudden, 18 points, 5 assists. He has been the catalyst.
Ticky-tack foul about 30 feet away from the basket. They call it on Mike Dahl.
Keene going 1-for-7 two nights ago. You knew he was going to look to be aggressive and assertive. And that has certainly been the case. Another situation where he's kind of lose track of him. Samaje Christen just totally encountering that Eric Thompson screen. The effort has got to be better than that. That's one of the best players in the history of this tournament right there.
That last foul on Mike Dahl is his fourth. He has to leave the game. Sideline Cancer, they get small. They bring in Remy Abel to replace Dahl.
Oh, wow. That's a terrible call.
And Abel picks up the foul. On the blue line.
Trayvon Blewett just said, as illegal of a screen as you will ever set. I mean, how is that not a, what?
And they call the foul on Abel.
Terrible call.
Riley to Chance back into the game for Zip 'em Up. This is LeChance. Oh my! Three-pointer LeChance! We're tied at 55.
I think of Riley LeChance. I think of a lot of just catch and shoot three opportunities, but they are showing the ability to go off the bounce and Zip 'em Up crowd back in the game.
Artis. Eric Thompson's been a difference maker on the glass. Deep. Oh my! Marcus Keene, another one.
He has had an answer for every Zip 'em Up run here tonight. You're right about Eric Thompson. You can see how he led the TBT in rebounding 2 years ago.
Christen scored the goal and a foul. Chance for three. Both teams have come alive here in the third quarter.
Marcus Keene in quite the rhythm. Now 5 of 8 from downtown and off the offensive rebound, a great time. Get a step in three. Samaje Christen playing pick and roll. He's got Remy Abel on an island. There's that contact. Abel with his left arm wrapped around the back of Christen. A really nice drive. Did not settle for that mid-range jumper. Got all the way to the rack.
Tied once more. Winner advances to take on Florida TNT tomorrow in the Xavier Regional Championship. And C.J. Miles got fouled. C.J. thought he was fouled multiple times.
He's thought that a lot tonight. He's felt that way pretty much the entire game. Actually, he lost the ball. There's the bump. A lot of that's initiated by C.J. Miles, though. To me, that's just a play on. I mean, he has really given that shoulder to Trayvon Blewett.
C.J. Miles, one of the best shooters in the NBA for 16 seasons, upset with himself missing that free throw. Think about pros. They don't miss two free throws in a row. This is down.
That will be tested here.
Yeah, down. Yeah. That was no pure. Way. Kristen Blewett, Johnson, Stainbrook, and LaChance. Five on the floor for Zip 'em Up. 1 point game. Samaje Kristen is starting to take over.
I love what he's doing. And it's all about getting to the basket. Once again, playing off 2 feet in that painted area. It's not a pull-up jumper. He is getting all the way.
And Marcus Keene is fouled while shooting a three. Or did he commit the foul?
Offensive foul.
Yep. He splayed the legs, and he fouls Blewett.
We've got the Reggie Miller rule here in effect. Marcus Keene going up. There's that right. He kicks that right leg out.
Yeah, it looks like Blewett said he got hit in the face.
In the face. It wasn't a crazy amount, but it was just enough to where he did establish that contact.
Kristen again.
Well, they like this matchup.
Put the head down and going straight to the cup. Missed the layup. Keene, middle of the court. Working to Steve Nash along the baseline, keeping the dribble alive.
Got a good look. It's amazing how when you do that Steve Nash dribble, it can free up looks for shooters. CJ Miles got a good one.
Stainbrook back out to Kristen. Settles.
Settles is right. He is living at the rim.
And we go into the 4 minute mark. We've got a timeout. 3:45 remaining, third quarter. Back and forth, nip and tuck. 1 point ball game.
Got it?
Thank you, I'm rolling behind you.
Maj, I'm giving you a quick break.
Coach, don't forget about the three. He's our leading scorer at halftime. Took him out first.
Who?
Three. Tanner's been out.
We'll go with 1 minute. Hey, so all the other guys, be ready to shoot. If you're this guy here, 45 cut as the ball screen's going on. But we're rolling to the basket, all right? Down here, we got to do a better job on the defensive end. We got to get out here. We got to put pressure on this guy, all right? So whoever that is, if it's the five, go up there. Let's jump in one time. Get underneath. If it's a four, just call out the switch. Really simple.
If I'm guarding three, how far you want me up? You want me up?
Oh, 3 points. NBA three. Here we go.
Let's go, y'all. Zip him up on three. 1, 2, 3.
Hey, you stay up. I need a three.
Hey, everybody rebound.
Hey, everybody rebound.
One-point ball game, 3:45 remaining, third quarter. The only place to get your official TBT gear is in the TBT store. Support your favorite team and TBT by picking up a hoodie or t-shirt today. Visit store.thetournament.com. Well, it was a three-point game. Zip 'em Up leading sideline cancer at the break. It is now a one-point game. Zip 'em Up leading sideline cancer. Shannon Bogues comes into the game to run the point. Marcus Keene's gonna get a rare blow. He's been huge in the third quarter. LaChance, the steal. D. Davis. He was the open man, but that probably wasn't the best look. Yeah, look at Remy Abel go. Fastest man on the floor, Remy Abel.
Blew by every Zip 'em Up defender, and what looked like was going to be numbers for Zip 'em Up ends up being a bucket in transition for sideline cancer.
For those of you who remember, Wilma Rudolph one point the fastest woman in the world. That is Remy Abel's aunt. 1960 Olympic champion, Wilma Rudolph. Direct relative of Remy Abel. That's maybe where he gets his speed.
Well, he's also Bo Jackson's nephew.
Is that crazy?
No, that is insane.
That's some good stock right there. All right, Sideline Cancer leads. They lead by a point. Bogues lost it on the way up. Picked off by Davis. Here comes LaChance. He's got Johnson. Didn't find him, and he got fouled.
That Euro foul again. LaChance bringing it in transition, and Tony Crocker, another guy that's an overseas vet. It's going to be, I think, a delay of game on Sideline Cancer for throwing the ball in the stands. Could have been a tech.
Yep. Well, zip them up. They're in the bonus, so LaChance is going to have free throws. Chance, but it's for LaChance. Man, did it get quiet in here. Well, the winning prize will be sent by Zell for Riley LaChance. His winning share, $52,000 and change. Fans can win two at thetournament.com/Zell. One out of two for LaChance. Roger Maris special, tied at 61. 2.5 remaining, third quarter.
It's the same move in the first half. Tony Crocker, he's catching that, trying to jab, and he's dragging that left pivot foot.
I tell you, Sideline Cancer is just trying to get some points here, but their main weapons, Dom, Miles, Keene, all sitting on the bench right now. You wonder where the offense is going to come from.
I guess we've seen Remy Abel in transition, and that's a great question.
Karim Cantor back in the game, working against McGlynn.
He's going left. He's coming back to his left hand.
Yeah.
Oh,
has
he's
to throw it up with the right, and it didn't work. Bogues, he saw a ghost. There's no one there. LaChance, got it!
He has come in and impacted the game off the bench in a big, big way.
He is the rare non-Xavier alum playing on this year's team. Remy Abel is fouled by Cantor. That's the fourth foul on Cantor.
Well, the chance now with 10 points. He is perfect from beyond the arc, 3 of 3. And this is another one off the bounce in transition. Shannon Bogues just a little bit lackadaisical in picking up the basketball. That's exactly what Riley LaChance wants to do. You are playing right into his hands, letting him shoot that from downtown. You've got to make him be a driver.
Which of his college coaches was the better shooter, Kevin Stallings or Bryce Drew?
I will tell you this. I was being recruited by Kevin Stallings to Vanderbilt, and I have seen him make 4 of 5 behind-the-back half-court shots.
No.
I swear to God. He came to my high school. I was in this local newspaper horse contest. He goes, check this out. He made 2 at my high school, and he made 2 at Vanderbilt on my visit back.
I've seen him. Goodness.
He's the king of behind-the-back half-court shots. So I don't know. Bryce or Kevin Stallings.
Blow it! Rebounded by night. Davis. 2 for 1. Yes! Blew it! Got it!
He's had to take the tougher one. Second one. Only contested.
Crocker knocked to the floor. We play on. Blow it ahead of the pack to Macura. Whips it over to LaChance.
This place would have exploded at Ekron. That was quite the pass from J.P. Macura.
C.J. Miles back into the game, just looking for some form of offense.
Trayvon blew it. Couldn't get the open one, but it's 2 for $1 here, and this is a pretty contested shot there by Shannon Bogues.
Sideline Cancer going deep to the bench. They bring in Mo Creek. Mo Creek has only played 2.5 minutes in our ball game.
How good to see him out here. Stuck in Ukraine. And honestly, the Sideline Cancer connection to bring him back. A retired Lieutenant Colonel, Eric Nordberg, his daughter had been a camper at one of Sideline Cancer's camps, and he got to know Mo Creek, and boy, just a terrifying situation of him being stuck playing in Ukraine, couldn't get out of the country, the war had started, and bombs were falling on the city he was in. So it's good to see him over here and give Sideline Cancer a ton of credit and Eric Nordberg a lot of credit for getting to know this young man and then coming into a situation and helping to get him out.
24-hour ordeal for Mo Creek. During that Russian invasion, yeah, scary, scary times. He's known a lot of adversity. Man, he was a big deal recruit, got up to a great start
in
his college career at Indiana. A lot of rehabbing, it was both a knee, it was an Achilles. Finished up his college career at George Washington. 6-point lead for Zip 'em Up. Final 40 seconds of our third quarter. Skip pass to Creek. And Creek is fouled. So the clock stops. Creek will have two free throws. That's the fifth foul on Cantor.
They just warned the Zip 'em Up bench, which is interesting because they've already had a tech on the bench.
Yeah, you'd think that would already kind of count as your warning.
I don't know what Karen Cantor can do there. And you want your big guys to go straight up, and he's going straight up.
Creek has always been an elite, elite shooter. Misses the first. So Cantor with those five fouls leaves. Stainbrook back into the game. One out of two for Creek. Five-point ball game. LaChance has got it. And in the bonus, LaChance is going to have two free throws. That is just giving free money to Zip 'em Up.
Marcus Kane is asking what he did. And he put two hands on him. A driver of the basketball. That's going to get called all night. I mean, he's just holding him.
And LaChance can't miss from three, but he can't make his free throw. LaChance is 3-for-4 from behind the arc, but he's only 2-for-5 as a free thrower.
Mike Dom coming back in for this last possession. Something to keep our eyes on here. He has been in some foul trouble here tonight.
Dahmer's got four fouls. Shot clock's off. Keen, Dom, Miles, Creek, Abel. Five on the floor for Sideline Cancer. A bucket here go a long way heading into the fourth quarter.
They got the switch they wanted, the chance on Keen. Now we'll see, can Zip 'em Up give enough help to keep Keen out of the paint.
Shot clock is down to two. Miles. And that will do it for our third quarter of play. Sideline Cancer, at one point, their first lead of the game, but then they surrender it and then some. Riley LaChance, a 9-point third quarter. The fourth is next in Cincinnati. The basketball tournament is presented by Puma Basketball and by Sling TV, the official streaming partner of TBT.
Trades to the corner. JP Maj. I'm sorry. Yeah, JP Maj Riley. Matt, set the back screen. JP, go through. Throw it to him. Same thing we did last game, right? Throw it to him. Come off this handoff. Play downhill with Trey. Matt, if you can't give it to Maj, dribble. Throw it for Riley. Slip. Nope. Maj is going to have it. You're just going to go straight off the back screen for a lob. Does that make sense? Hey, fellas, keep fighting, all right? Keep fighting. Fist Spain works, obviously, right? We can look to throw back. The other one is keep rebounding when you get a chance, run. If you get it, clip it. Let's go.
Be hey, solid, man.
Hey, guys, don't complain to the refs. We Xavier. No excuses. No excuses. We play through it. Play through it.
1, 2, 3.
Let's
go.
Let's go.
Finish it.
Let's go, man.
Thank you.
JP Maj. I'm sorry. Yeah, JP Maj Riley. Matt, set the back screen. JP, go through. Throw it to him. Same thing we did last game, right? Throw it to him. Come off his handoff. Play downhill with Trey. Matt, if you can't give it to Maj, dribble. Throw for Riley. Slip. Nope. Maj is going to have it. You're just going to go straight off the back screen for a lob. Does that make sense? Hey, fellas, keep fighting, all right? Keep fighting. Points.
All right, that was Rick Carter. He's done a bang-up job drawing up plays. Seems like every time he's drawn a play, it's been productive.
Let's see if they get the lob. It's also sometimes tough for players. It doesn't seem like it should be hard, but to carry it over and run a play after you play start the defensive end, there can be some slippage there.
Six-point ball game as we get our fourth quarter. C.J. Miles, I'll tell you, that's some strong fingers. That was a loose ball, and he just ripped off the ground.
He had Stainbrook off the bounce, and you're right. Had to go down and get it, stayed composed, and scored it at the basket.
All right, here's the play that Rick Carter had drawn up. And Stainbrook is fouled. That foul wasn't on Mike Dahm, but it's important to remember, Mike Dahm is on the floor with four fouls. Dahm has not been his usual dominant self. He had 31 points on Monday.
He's only taken five shots here.
Yeah, he's only got 9 points. Stainbrook leaves the game. He's replaced by Kaiser Gates. So it's Gates, LaChance, Kristen, Macura, and Blewett playing for Zip 'em Up.
Watch Gates on a lob here. It's because LaChance is on the same side. Stainbrook's
actually going all the way back to the locker room. He had blood in the back of his pants in the third quarter. I don't know if that had anything to do with it. Riley LaChance working on Keene. And Keene did a great job. 5'9" tall, and Keene did a good job. Winner of this game will take on Florida TNT tomorrow. Dahm. That's a big time score. That is a man who is 6'9" tall. Dribble relocation and knocks it down to make it a 1 point game.
It's a dangerous pick and pop right there with Marcus Keene and Mike Dahm.
Samaje Kristen, he's at his best when he's doing that.
Sideline Kings are trying to push up on the screener and then go under, but end up having a double screen. They didn't do a good enough job of doing it early, and that's just right to the rim for Samaje Kristen.
Bad pass picked off by Macura. LaChance. Kristen missed the layup. Sideline Cancer down three. They clear it out for Dahm. And he tried to keep that pivot foot down. He couldn't do it. It's a walk. All right, when we go underneath the four-minute mark, the first stoppage, we will have the game clock turned off, and we'll have an elim ending.
I'm not sure he did. It looked weird.
Yeah,
sometimes that can be enough to
guilty of looking weird.
Trigger a call, but I don't think he moved that pivot foot either.
Uh-oh. Kristen's been a lot better at attacking the rim than settling for jumpers. Uh-oh. Gates banked one home from the top of the key.
And third down.
Careless with the basketball. Blew it.
Shot selection here is questionable at best.
That's a good shot for C.J. Miles, and he missed everything. C.J. Miles, 1,250 NBA three-pointers. That's a good shot for him. He just missed it. All right, we've got a timeout. Both teams are going to try and figure things out at the 6:43 mark of our fourth quarter. Points in the paint has been decidedly in favor of Zip 'em Up.
Think about Samaje Kristen, able to drive inside that painted area. They've been able to throw it in to Karim Cantor as well. But at times, both teams have fallen in love with some wild shots from the perimeter. And missed opportunities, but sideline Cantor is 15 of 26 from the foul line. They have left a ton of points out at that free throw line.
Another game going on out in New York, Rucker Park. Regional final. Live look in as that game is a little bit behind ours.
Hope it's a calm night in New York City, because shooting outside when it's windy can be a challenge.
Find that game on ESPN.
Maybe by the judge of the score, it's not.
Keene's got a game high 24. Shaded by Nate Johnson's just chucked into the game. Keene, beautiful layup.
Nate Johnson trying to pressure the basketball, and Marcus Keene just so good at using that ball screen. Now he's got one-on-one with Kaiser Gates, and he gets right by him.
Sideline Cancer had to win a nail biter in their game on Monday to zip them up. They had a blowout win over Sweet Home Alabama.
Good
Gates
cut by Nate Johnson.
Back out to Macura. He's had an off night. Loose ball picked up by Keene.
Nate Johnson's cut totally makes that play for J.P. Macura, and he'll take that all night.
Dahl, and that gives Sideline Cancer the lead.
Marcus Keene threw that from the X at the middle of the floor. Mike Dahl had just sealed off J.P. Macura, and Keene wisely throwing it up to him.
Kristen doesn't settle and scores.
And he's gone to the rim. Good things have happened for Zip 'Em Up.
Back and forth here, 5.5 remaining. Minute and a half before our Elam ending. Tom!
You gotta pre-rotate to that. That is really fortunate. You cannot let Mike Dahl pick and pop. He will just eat you alive. You better go in. That's a
shot.
Terrible shot.
That was it, quickie. And wow, maybe a hometown call as Kaiser Gates hits the deck. They're gonna say the ball stays with Zip 'Em Up.
Nate Johnson, if you've made two or three, I'm with it, but we're getting late in the game. Every possession is so important. Do your work on the offensive glass, you get another chance at this thing, but that is not a good shot. He traveled.
We haven't mentioned it a lot, but Sideline Cancer has played a large chunk of the second half without Eric Thompson. Eric Thompson was elite for a portion of that first half.
It's a rebounding
offensive
machine.
Rebounding, defensive presence, but he's been unavailable. We've seen a lot of Jamel Artis, who's got the ball now, over to Keene. Keene gets inside, missed the layup. Blew it. Fumbles it,
there.
Able
freak.
To keep possession.
Sense of urgency there. He knew Trayvon Blewett wanted to let that go.
That's a tough chance. Oh my goodness! Score the goal and a foul! The most impressive thing was the catch of that pass. Nate Johnson, chance for a 4-point play.
Couldn't have come at a better time as we're approaching that Elam ending. This pass is extremely low, which normally is going to throw you out of rhythm. When that ball is outside of your midsection, you're going to have a really strong core to be able to bring that back in and elevate immediately. I believe that was Jamel Artis, just a little over-aggressive on the closeout. You don't let him land, and a huge opportunity here for that 4-point play.
Oh, my goodness. How big was that? What had been a 1-point lead is now a 5-point lead. This may be Sideline Cancer's last possession before the Elam ending. Cancer back into the game is fouled by Dahl. That's the fifth foul on Mike Dahl.
The loudspeaker just said that was 6 on Dahl.
We have 5.
I'm pretty sure that's what the announcer just said.
I heard it as well, but it's 5.
Well, home cooking.
Oh, no, now the officials are saying it is 6. And they're telling Dahl he's fouled out.
Wow. Yeah.
But Dahl doesn't agree.
Stat broadcast does not agree. That says five.
We told you he'd been playing with four for a long time, yeah. And he didn't pick up one. So we're going to have an official timeout, and they're going to get to the bottom of this.
Yeah. I got you. We're going to get it right.
Now I vividly remember when he got his fourth, and he hasn't had one since. Yes. It should be five from what we've been tracking
evening long.
That's
five personal fouls for him.
They got it right.
Yes, five.
All right, so it is five on Dom. He'll be able to stay in the game.
But what an advantage there for Zip 'em Up. Give Rick Carter an opportunity to bring your group in. He has been dynamite drawing up plays. You get to treat that as a pseudo timeout. Let's see what they run here.
Zip 'em Up playing in front of a lot of friendly faces. Xavier alumni team playing here at Cintas Center, which is the home floor for Xavier. Once we go into the 4-minute mark, the first stoppage, we'll take off the game clock and play to an Elam ending.
They went straight ISO. I'm shocked that that's the shot that they got.
Out of bounds, it'll be Xavier ball. We do not go under the 4-minute mark. Remy Abel's back on the floor along with Eric Thompson. Thompson was the man who replaced Mike Dahm. This is just kind of a defensive situation. Dahm playing with five fouls. Macura. Run out from Miles. Had his pocket picked. Blew it. And now a foul called. Samaje Kristen fouls to stop the game clock and set our Elam ending. So the target score will be 87. 8 points added to the Zip 'em Up total, so 87 will be the point total to get to. We'll be back with an Elam ending in a moment. Well, it has all come down to this here in TBT. All games end on a slingshot. It's sponsored by Sling TV, home of the best deal for streaming sports, news, and entertainment. Zip 'em Up. They had a lead heading into under the 4-minute mark, and now that we have a stoppage, 8 points are added to their total, and so the target score is 87. The game clock is just wiped away. We're still going to play the shot clock. But the target score, 87. Whoever gets there first, zip them up for sideline cancer, will win the ball game and advance to take on Florida TNT tomorrow.
Nate Johnson for zip him up is going to have to really give great effort defending this man right here. It's going to be the Marcus Keene show in pick and roll action.
And Blewett and Dahm got tangled up.
They call it on Dahm. He would have been done, but ends up going against Blewett.
And they called it on. I don't even know who they called it.
They got it on Trayvon Blewett.
I thought I saw six fingers up. That would have been Samaje Christen, but neither here nor there. It is on Blewett. It's the fourth foul on Blewett. All right, let's see what sideline cancer can do on this out of bounds play. Keene, that's a clean look for him. Bottom of the well, Marcus Keene.
Miscommunication there. It was J.P. Macura and I believe Trayvon Blewett. They tried to switch that screen for the screener action and ends up being a wide open one. Two go with C.J. Miles and Marcus Keene wide open.
Christen, I'll tell you, when he goes to the cup, man, he's elite.
He's going to the basket if you're Samaje Christen.
Target score is 87. C.J. Miles gets two for sideline cancer.
We will see. Can sideline cancer keep Samaje Christen out of the paint?
Remy Abel's sideline is on him right now. Abel probably the best defender that sideline cancer has, trying to not be switched off on.
This is going to be his show. He's got to drive this thing.
Cantor!
Wow!
Oh! What a time for a four-point play. That is massive. Eric Thompson just couldn't stop himself. If Cantor can hit this free throw, it is going to be 2 4-point plays in the last 3 minutes. For zip him up.
Hardly ever see it, but it has been a huge factor here down the stretch.
Nope, but it still gives zip him up an opportunity to win next time they come down the floor. First team to 87 wins. Keene got fouled. Marcus Keene knows how to play this game.
He just gets wherever he wants on the floor. They send him a ball screen and going to find his way to get downhill. Samaje Christen pleading his case, and he was straight up. Well, he was pretty straight up. That's been a call that has been questionable all night. This guy's trying to contest in a legal fashion. And the offensive player is making contact, but it's been called a foul almost all night.
Bad miss for Keene. Sideline cancer needs everything they can get. One out of two for Keene. Zip him up can win with a three.
Doesn't mean you have to settle.
Cantor and Christen both wearing Pumas. If they make this Elam ending winning slingshot, they get an extra 1,000. For the 1,000 and the win!
I will say this, I think I gave you bad information. I think Samaje Christen's wearing Under Armour, but it's hard to tell because they look very similar to the Pumas. But I know you asked me earlier during a quarter change, but now that I look, I'm pretty sure he's not eligible. It's
okay.
Cantor and Cantor
Remy,
only.
Cantor only, all right. Thank you for the clarification.
I take blame. I told you that I thought they were Pumas, but I was wrong.
Sideline cancer, they need to score. Here comes Macura. I bet he's going to fire.
Oh, he went game. Wow. Why is he shooting? Now is a wide open three.
Creek with the misfire. No damage done for Zip him up. And now Rick Carter saying, you know
that's
what?
A good time.
We're going to get a good shot.
That's a really good time.
I always think strategy this late to get a two. the two is going to be wide open.
Then it opens up the entire floor that every shot will win the game.
And we're going to listen into Rick Carter and see what he has to say.
Hey, everyone listen. Hey, listen. Guys, let's listen. Listen. We got two possessions, and we're going to end the game, all right? Here we go. Let's calm down, then we can talk about it. Mosh, you're going to go off Trey. Trey, Cam, I want you three to roll. Trey, I want you to curl it. When you come off this, if you get attacked to the right, go ahead. If not, continue with the ball screen, turn it into Spain. Back screen for Cam, roll. Weak side, flare, slip. All right? Here we go.
Let's go, y'all. Finish it, man. Let's go. Finish on three. 1, 2, 3.
Did you get anything out of that, Robbie?
Hard to tell.
Yeah.
Without being, it wasn't easy to hear and came to the board.
So zip them up, they can win with a three here. But you can't go over. If you get two, you get yourself 86 points, you get a two the next time down, that'll work.
Honestly, if I'm Rick Carter, I'm putting the ball in the hands of Samaje Christie. I'm just, it's pick and roll, off the bounce. Drive the basketball and make a play for yourself or somebody else.
Nate Johnson will inbound. Johnson, Macura, Kristen, Cantor, Blewett, the five on the floor for Zip 'em Up. Trying to win and move on to tomorrow's game against Florida TNT. Kristen working on Abel. Cantor! He has been Johnny on the spot all ball game. 21 points, 11 rebounds for Cantor. And Dahlem is fouled by Blewett. Blewett, his fifth personal foul.
Shot blockers coming over, and they're guarding Karim Cantor. Eric Thompson coming to block. Actually, it ends up, that is Eric Thompson. And because of that, he's got Cantor. Nobody helping the helper.
Sideline Cantor missing free throws at a time of the game where they can't afford to miss free throws. Dahlem is saying that there's a wet spot on the floor.
And look back at this game, 16 of 28 from the foul line. Opportunities left at the free throw line.
And Mike is like, there's still a wet spot. Not sure if a wet spot can cause a missed free throw.
This can also be a rest tactic. Your heart's beating fast, and there's a wet spot.
Earlier today, Florida TNT, a winner over the Fort Wayne champs. Tomorrow night will be the championship game of the Xavier Regional. One out of two for Dahlem. Sideline Cantor, they need a stop or their run is over. Kristen along the baseline for the win. Remy Abel is fouled. Good golly. That almost went in. That'd have been a chance for a three-point play.
Give a lot of credit to Remy Abel for putting pressure on this defense here in transition off this runout, but yeah, just wipe it down like that. That's a dangerous play from Nate Johnson.
Remy Abel, a former Xavier Musketeer, playing against a lot of familiar faces. Makes them both. And another timeout called by Zip 'em Up. Target score is 87. Anytime the ball goes through that rim, it'll be over for Zip 'em Up. They need a free throw, they need a two, a three, doesn't make a difference. If they score, it's over and on to the third round.
This is a big possession here. And from having played in this event, the pressure that builds with the Elam ending as a team puts game pressure on you. You don't finish this here, and let's say Sideline Cancer hits a three to make it a one-possession game and one possession within winning that thing at 84. It just gives a different type of pressure that we don't necessarily have a ton of in the normal game. It's something that's unique to the TBT, where there is no, hey, let's just hold the ball and get fouled. You've got to win the game. So a really big possession here for Zip 'em Up and Rick Carter's ball club.
Same five on the floor for Zip 'em Up.
If you're Sideline Cancer, you can't foul here because that'd be the fifth foul, and that would give Zip 'em Up one free throw and the ball back.
Cantor.
This is going up.
Macura for the win. It's over! JP Macura. Slingshot to win the ball game for Zip 'em Up. Zip 'em Up wins their second game. Here, the 2022 TBT, they will advance to the Xavier Regional Final tomorrow night against Florida TNT. And JP McCurry did it on top of his buddy, Mike Dahl.
Crossover, it's a heck of a move. On a night where he didn't shoot the ball well, that's a guy that, if they're not going down, his confidence will never, ever waver.
Putting Sideline Cancer to sleep. So congratulations to Zip 'em Up. They take down Sweet Home Alabama on Monday. They take down Sideline Cancer on Wednesday. And now they'll have Florida TNT tomorrow evening on this floor. This year, E&J Brandy awarding $10,000 to the team with the best post-game celebration. And we're waiting for Zip 'em Up to go put their, advance their team name into the Xavier Regional Final.
Come on! Come on!
JP McCura is, uh-oh. We have a special. DJ Raymond is bringing down a guest presenter, I think, to put up the Zip 'em Up logo. Well, this may not be the best post-game celebration, but it's certainly the most drawn-out post-game celebration.
Come on, sister!
Come on, sister!
Come on, sister!
Where are you?
So this is Sister Fleming. And Sister Fleming is going to be tasked with advancing Zip 'em Up into the Xavier Regional Final. TNT tomorrow night here from the Cintas Center in Cincinnati. Wasn't easy for Zip 'em Up. And Sideline Cancer, they had their chances in the second half. It was back and forth. We were tied a whole bunch of times. But zip them up. They advance for the second time in 3 days, and they are now in our round three. It'll come your way tomorrow night, Thursday night, 7 o'clock Eastern time. You can find it on ESPN3.
And balance has really been the story for Zip 'em Up, and it was the case again tonight. Karim Cantor was tremendous. I think Samaje Christen also great minutes from him, especially when he attacked the basket, got to the rim. There was a lot of other guys. Riley LeChance really sticks out. There was just a lot of guys that contributed to this win over a very, very good sideline Cantor team.
And it looks like Rucker Park, their regional final is about to be over. It is a 1 point away for a Americana for Autism. Target score 67, they've got 66.
I just think it's so cool that one of the legendary courts in the history of this game, Rucker Park, is being utilized now in TBT, and the crowds there have just been tremendous all week.
Last bucket, always so hard to get. Folks, if you'd like to catch the end of this, it is on ESPN, and it's getting close. Wow. HBC United is now, they are 4 points away from the target score. So it's at teeth gnashing time. Sure hope you enjoyed this one. It's been fun. We've had two games today, a winner Florida TNT in our first one, and Zip 'em Up, Xavier alumni team, a winner in our second game. Those two will clash tomorrow for the right to head to Dayton for championship week. Robbie Hummel, fun working with you, my man.
Always a pleasure. We'll do it again tomorrow.
We will. Get some rest. All right, we'll come back your way. It's a 7 o'clock Eastern time tomorrow for the Xavier regional final. It'll be Zip 'em Up and Florida TNT. Zip 'em Up, a winner over sideline Cantor by 8. Good night from Cincinnati.
A recap for both. Zip 'em Up, Sideline Cantor, Fort Wayne Champs. Okay. Cool. Dude, down the wrong tube cough was.
Yeah, and I was like, which one's that button?
That was funny.
Well, after that 2.5 minutes waiting for Sister Fleming to come down, I'm pretty sure there's no one watching
that
at that point.
The pressure is building here. This guy's turning it over.
Yeah, I have no interest. Can we just do this and get out of here? Okay.
Damn. I love B.J. Raymond here, that's for sure.
It's a big bucket here. That's a big bucket. Ooh, body's flying.
Americana for the win. Oh, that's going to be
a foul.
He
got him a free throw. This guy, like,
he can't believe.
90?
I don't know. He looks like
We're not waiting for this game to be over before we do this, right?
In March, so far tonight, is 3 of 4 from the line. But he did miss his last one.
And this is a pressure free
Please
throw.
God, make this. Is he wearing
This is not ones? Playing against Wachita Baptist right now. Now Arkansas.
What if he went to the bench?
This,
like, give me
this
the Pumas.
This puts you in a position to be
the
game closer to a million.
Absolutely. So he'll get two shots.
Just went out there, untied shoes, and made the free throw.
Okay, guys,
I'm wondering
two shots.
Why it's not one
two
and
shots.
Ball out of bounds. Unless they said it was in the act.
In the act.
Yep.
March. It's two shots. This one for the win. It gets the roll. That's what you call a slingshot. Sponsored by Sling TV. Home of the best deal for streaming sports, news, and entertainment. And Autism Army is headed to Championship Week.
Halfway to $1 million. Three wins at Rucker Park.
Is there a camera up there?
They will head today, Tiny Morton and his team, a veteran team. They were tested, trailed by 4 at the half.
Okay.
Oh my God.
What happened?
Did you see that guy's hair?
No, it wasn't.
Oh my God. I've never seen anyone playing basketball with that type of hair. It was
like afro?
It was Kenny no, it was Kenny Boynton times 5. The amount of dreads he had.
Nice.
Oh my goodness. I had him last year. Can't remember. Delroy James, maybe?
That sounds right. Champ week. That's a confusing graphic.
I know.
It's because it's a Xavier regional, but yeah. It looks like
you're so there's one team that, yeah.
I think two teams had clinched, maybe.
Yeah. I was like, Syracuse, they won't win.
Yeah. All right. This is taking a long time.
Yeah. We have been standing by.
We're starting with the first game.
You can't tell me you guys weren't waiting for this game to be over before we did this. No.
No, let's roll.
Here in Cincinnati, Ohio, the Xavier Regional Round 2 is now complete. Two games this evening in the books. In our first one, what a performance by Florida TNT. Man, they have breezed so far through this year's field. They are off to a good start with Robbie Hummel. I am Eric Collins. Let's talk about Florida TNT.
Well, some different characters here in tonight's game took over for Florida TNT, and the big fella absolutely phenomenal. Keith Clanton, 22 points. He goes 10 of 11 from the field. That man as well, Chris Warren, lights out. He was driving the basketball. He was making shots from the perimeter. 6 of 12 from the three-point line. Jonathan Holton in the Pumas gets the slingshot as well and the $1,000. Florida TNT moving on.
Florida TNT riding Chris Warren, who had 21 of his 24 points in the second half. In our nightcap, zip him up, taking on sideline cancer.
Boy, Marcus Keene really kept sideline cancer in this game. 30 points, 6 of 10 from 3. He's C.J. Miles and Mike Dom were the offense, but the zip him up balance, too much to deal with. Karim Cantor, phenomenal. We saw Samaje Christian again. When he got downhill and got to the basket, he was almost unguardable. Then J.P. Macura, tough night shooting the basketball, not on the slingshot. He sends his team to the final here. The hometown crowd was loving it.
All right, so we have two rounds complete. We will have a Xavier Regional Championship played tomorrow between the number one seed, Florida TNT, and the three seed, but there's going to be a lot of friendly faces as Zip 'em Up, a Xavier alumni team playing here at the Cintas Center.